can now be met in a sea of green. We're here today to sit and watch the champions play. With a four-leaf clover on my breast and the green and white upon my chest, it's such a joy for us to see. For they play football the Celtic way, with a four-leaf clover on my breast and the green and white upon my chest. It's such a joy for us to see, for they play football the Celtic way, for they play football the Celtic way, for they play football the Celtic way, 'cause they play football the Celtic way.
And we're back. What you should never do, kids, is eat a dime bar when you're doing a radio show. Right? Don't ever eat a dime bar. I've just started to eat a dime bar there. And, it's messy. It's a messy event. We're playing this for any zombie. If you're a zombie, here you go. This is just for you. We'll be right back.
Vu, located on Main Street. This is Jennifer. How may I help you?
Can't be bothered with Jennifer. We only like Stephanie. Right, I'm going to introduce something that I never thought I would do, but I'm going to do it now. I think I have to. I'm going to have to play this because it's a bit of a... How can I put it? It's a bit of a sad moment, yes. But let's crack on. Hi, this is Simple Simon. I've not met a pieman yet. But this story goes back, for me, a personal story. Yes, it goes back to 2012, to be exact. Picture the scene. Valentine's Day, 2012. A club is crushed under the weight of the juggernaut called Craigie Boy White. The Fenian maestro, he played a dancer and he killed the chancers. He took them to new levels that they thought could not be possible. Yes, we cried, please be possible. Please give us our dreams, our wishes. And one by one, they walked away, or they fell away. And we triumphed. For me, I remind you of all this. Not that you have forgotten any of it. Oh no, how could we? There is no way any of us could forget the story of how Rangers died and how Sevco began. The part that all the players played in all this. And for myself, a little half-witted crackpot Fenian who has dared to phone some of these shysters. And I pay special respect to the hallowed board called the Huddle Board. Yes, and the day that I made the Craig White call, the first call, I thought I was hoaxed by the good people of the Huddle Board. I had to listen to the call again and listen to a clip of him on YouTube. Such was my shock that I had just spoken to the king of the dupers. Craigie Boy White had duped David Murray, who had duped the Royal Bank itself out of over £600-700 million. Bankrupt the Bank of Scotland, had to be bailed out by the British taxpayer. And here was I, talking to the person who'd duped the King Duper. How is it possible? I thought. These things don't happen. And we're back. You have missed nothing at all. An extended bit of silence from our friends in the Noise Abatement Society. And we're back with the story. Chillax. Take it easy. Use beneficial herbs if you have to. The story involves, well, a full load of crack pottery. So, we start again. Before I do, I need to reposition myself because this is fucking killing me. But anyway, right, there we go, that's better. Right, sorry about that. A slight inversion of Tourette's. You never heard Simon Bates with that shit. Right, so, where were we? I need to put this other earphone in or else to get the full effect of this music. That's better, yes. So, right. So Craigie Boy White gave the bears such a fright, and I thought after that first call that I could do another call. And so I plotted of how to get the Craigie Boy back on the line. I was told to be patient. I already had done something so remarkable. Chill out. And the plans were underway, set in motion by the other good people of the Huddle Board to continue the scam. As I say, it wasn't all just about me. I was a small cog in a big wheel, a crackpot wheel of duping the duper of dupers, yes. And so the Huddle Board swung into motion, getting T-shirts. The Devil's Advocate, who had posed as an Ibrox blogger, had sent another email to Craigie Boy White. Craigie Boy White had said yes, he was quite impressed with Stuart Henderson, a man that he could do business with, and was eager to hear more. Well, that was an egg rad to a bull. I was even more desperate to speak to Craigie Boy White. I had to be tied down by my good friends. Stay calm, they said. Stay calm, crackpot. Stay feckin' calm, they said. How dare they? If it was a crackpot of crackpots that I was about to try and speak to for a second time. And so on that Sunday night, I sent him a message. I had phoned him on the Saturday. The first call was conducted on the Thursday. I was desperate for a second call. I was told, chill out, crackpot, chill out. I chilled out to the Saturday. I phoned him. No response. I panicked. I was desperate. I sent him a text on the Sunday night. He did not reply. I was absolutely fucking grief-stricken. Yes, I'll say it again. I was absolutely fucking grief-stricken. I felt betrayed. How could he blank me this way after what I had spoken to him? Had I been busted? The paranoid Fenian conspiracy crackpot heated me came ripping right to the top. Yes, the paranoia was ripping the pish right out me. The pish was getting right out my Archibald, I tell you that for nothing. I thought he'd jilted me. No more second call. A sex had been sent, a call had been made, until the Monday morning. On the Monday morning, as I stepped off a plane, I was in transit. I was in transit from one place to another. A top secret black ops mission that I could probably reveal at a cost, but I shan't here. But anyway, I was in transit, and as I walked off the plane into a cafe, I received a text from the